Good morning, students. Last class we have discussed about the factors affecting compaction. Okay. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about field compaction and the experiment to find out the field compaction. Okay. And this compaction process is very much familiar to you, that you may be seeing the compaction process which is taking place before road construction or before any building construction. That is, in both the in any type of construction, initially we are leveling the ground surface, and by applying little more water, we are compacting the soil by any of the method. In the case of road construction, by rollers, any type of rollers, we can compact the soil. In all these processes, we are compacting the soil in order to attain maximum red density. Okay, in any cases, we are compacting the soil in order to attain the maximum red density. And this maximum red density is attained when we are applying water, and this water content should be equal to optimum moisture content to have maximum red density. Okay, so this field compaction, I think it is very familiar to you, and all of you have maybe seen this process. That is, before any type of building construction or before road construction, etc. Okay, so for field compaction, the soil is spread in layers, and a predetermined amount of water is sprayed on each layer of the soil. That is, predetermined amount of water means in different types of soil, the amount of water to be added is different. That is, in the case of coarse soil and coarse soil, the water to be added is different. So that particular amount of water is added or sprayed in each layer of the soil, after which the compaction is initiated by any type of roller. Okay. In addition to soil type and moisture content, other factors must be considered to achieve the desired unit weight of compaction in the field. We have to consider so many factors other than this soil type and water content. And these factors include the thickness of lift, the intensity of pressure applied by the compacting equipment, and the area over which the pressure is applied. So considering all these factors, we are applying the compaction in field. These factors are important because the pressure applied at the surface decreases with depth. When depth increases, the pressure which is to be applied decreases. Okay, which results in decrease in the degree of soil compaction. During compaction, the dry unit weight of the soil also is affected by the number of roller passes. The dry unit weight of a soil at a given moisture content increases to a certain point with number of roller passes. That is, when the rollers passes over the soil, the dry density increases. Okay. In most specifications for earthwork, the contractor is instructed to achieve a compacted field dry unit weight of 90 to 95% of maximum dry unit weight determined in the laboratory by either the standard or modified proctor test. That is, in the we are usually determining the this compaction or maximum compact. This effect of compaction is expressed in the terms of maximum dry density, dry unit weight. Okay, so in the field we are obtaining a particular amount of dry unit weight for any type of soil, and this is done using standard proctor test or modified proctor test. But in field we cannot attain this 100% unit weight that we have obtained in the laboratory. Okay, so in field, maximum we can attain a dry unit weight of 90 to 95% of the maximum dry unit weight that we have obtained in the laboratory. Okay, so in any earthwork, the contractors are expecting to have a dry unit weight of 90 to 95% of the maximum dry unit weight which have been attained for that soil in the laboratory. Okay, so this factor we can represent in terms of relative compaction. The specification for relative compaction can be expressed as R is equal to the dry density which is obtained in the field divided by the maximum dry density which is obtained in the laboratory. In laboratory, we are obtaining maximum dry density because we are using the laboratory conditions, and we are using modified or standard proctor test, and we are compacting the soil in different layers, and each layer has given so many times of tamping. Okay, so in laboratory we are getting maximum dry density, but in field we are not getting this full dry density. Okay, so this ratio can be expressed in terms of relative compaction. So relative compaction is equal to the dry unit weight which is obtained in the field divided by the maximum dry unit weight which is obtained in the laboratory. Usually it is expressed in percentage, so into 100%. So next is the compaction control test. In order to control the compaction in the field, there are so many experiments. This compaction control tests are essential to check whether the objectives of compaction are achieved. Okay, so the main objective of compaction is to obtain maximum dry density. So in order to check whether the soil has attained the maximum dry density, there are some compaction control tests. Okay, so it is difficult to check the objectives directly, and property strength and compressibility are assessed indirectly. Okay, we cannot check these objectives directly. Control test in terms of water content, density, penetration resistance are conducted. Okay, for checking this, we are doing control test in terms of water content, density and penetration resistance. So the determination of relative compaction requires the following finding. To determine the relative compaction or the effect of compaction in the field, we have to find out in situ bulk density and field moisture content. These two parameters we have to find out in order to check whether our compaction is effective. That is, we have to find out bulk density and moisture content or water content. Then the in situ density can be computed by any of the following methods. That is density. In order to find out the density, there are different methods that we have studied in first module. We have discussed about Kolkata method, and another method is sand replacement method, and there is rubber balloon method also. These methods are used for finding out the in situ density. Okay. Next, determination of water content of compacted soil. Then we have to find out the water content of the compacted soil. Okay, usually in the laboratory, what is the method to find out water content? To find out the water content, usually we are doing oven drying method. Okay, but this oven drying, that is 24 hours oven drying method, is lengthy and cannot be used in the field. So in field, we have to have a short and simple method, that is Proctor needle method. Okay, and the so this is one of the important experiment or important test, that is Proctor needle method, and this method is used to determine the water content of compacted soil in the field. Okay, so principle of Proctor needle method. The basic principle of Proctor needle method is to determine the water content of compacted soil indirectly without drying the sample, based on the resistance offered by the compacted soil to the penetration of Proctor needle. Okay, here we are finding out the water content of compacted soil. That is, we are finding out the water content indirectly. And here we are not drying the sample. Okay, and also here we are finding out the water content based on the resistance offered by the compacted soil to the penetration of Proctor needle. So the main principle is we are finding out the water content without drying the sample. Okay, and here we are finding out the water content based on the resistance offered by the compacted soil to the penetration of Proctor needle. It will be discussed. So this is Proctor needle, and the components are, there is a loading plunger and there is a sliding ring and graduations. These graduations are indicated to find out the penetration resistance. To read the penetration resistance, there are graduations, and bottom there is needle shank and needle point. Okay, and this part is inserted into the soil, so there is needle, and this area of the needle point varies with different types of soil. If it is clay, the area should be somewhat larger than that of sand. Okay, like that, there is a needle shank and needle point, and here also there will be graduations to find out the depth up to which the needle is inserted into the soil. Okay, we are inserting the needle into the soil. Okay, so to find out the depth of insertion, there is some graduations at the needle shank. So this is the parts of Proctor needle. And Proctor needle consists of a needle attached to a spring-loaded plunger. Needle attached to plunger. The needle consists of a needle point attached to the bottom of needle shank. Needle point attached to the needle shank, and the needle can be pushed into the compacted soil by pressing the loading plunger. By pressing this plunger, we can insert the needle point into the soil. The needle shank has graduations to read the penetration of the needle into the compacted soil, and the stem of the loading plunger has graduations to show the resistance. Okay, that I have explained. That is, here there is graduations to show the resistance, and here there is graduations to know the depth. The loading plunger is calibrated to indicate the penetration resistance of the compacted soil based on the deformation of the spring, which depends on the load applied and the spring constant. The calibration is based on the load applied and the spring constant based on the deformation. And the needle points of different, the needle points of different cross-sectional areas are supplied along with the equipment such as 0.25, 0.51, 2.5 cm square to use in compacted soil of increasing penetration resistance. That is, this needle point may be having different cross-section that I have told you that for clay soil, the area will be more than that of sand. Likewise, we are changing the area. A needle may be, different types of needle will be there. So, based on the type of soil, we are changing the needle. Okay. So, the area may be 0.25 cm square, 0.5 cm square, etc. These are the components of Proctor needle. Okay. So, first method, before finding out the water content in the field, we have to calibrate the Proctor needle. That is the initial step, calibration. We have to find out the calibration chart. To use the Proctor's needle to determine the water content, it is required to prepare a calibration chart with the soil used for compaction. So, for that, suitable needle point is selected and attached to the bottom of the needle. Based on type of soil, suitable needle point is selected. While conducting the compaction test, the penetration resistance of the compacted soil in the mold is determined using Proctor needle of suitable needle point. Then, soil is compacted at a given water content in the compaction mold. That is, we are filling the mold with the soil and the soil is compacted at a particular water content. After the compaction is completed, the collar is removed, excess soil is removed, surface is leveled. Okay. That is, initially we are placing the soil in the mold and it is compacted and the initial surface is leveled. That is the initial step. Then the Proctor needle is used. For the Proctor needle is now placed on the surface of the compacted soil in the mold and forced down by 7.5 cm into the compacted soil at the rate of 1.25 cm per second. The rate of application of this Proctor needle is 1.25 cm per second. At this rate, this Proctor needle is inserted into the compacted soil for 7.5 cm. Okay. Then the penetration is checked from the graduations on the needle and the penetration resistance is read from the graduations on the stem of the loading plunger. That is, penetration resistance is read from the stem graduations on stem of the loading plunger corresponding to the position of sliding ring. Okay. So, we are inserting the Proctor needle into the soil for 7.5 cm at this rate and from the graduations on the stem of the loading plunger, we are noting down the penetration resistance. Then the water content and dry density of the compacted soil is determined by oven drying method as usually done in the compaction test. Water content and dry density is calculated as we have done in standard or modified test. This procedure is repeated by compacting the soil at different water content as in the compaction test and determine the penetration resistance at each water content. That is, here in the first case we have find out the penetration resistance from the graduations of the plunger. Next we are increasing the water content and also inserting the needle for 7.5 cm at 1.25 cm per second and note down the reading on the plunger. Okay. Then a compaction curve is plotted as we have done in compaction test between water content and dry density. In each of this water content, we are finding out the dry density and water content also as in the previous experiment. Okay. So on the same graph, of compaction curve that we have plotted in the previous experiments, that is in standard and modified, the penetration resistance is also plotted in the same graph. The area of the needle point is noted on the calibration chart. Okay. So see this graph here. In x-axis there is moisture content, water content on x-axis. In this axis there is dry density. Okay. So for particular moisture content, that is for 6%, if we are adding moisture content 6%, we have calculated dry density. Okay, that we have done in modified or standard Proctor test. Likewise, we have drawn this compaction curve. Okay, okay, the procedure to find out the convection curve you have studied. So, okay, parallelly we are doing the calibration of this Proctor needle. Okay, for that, for particular water content, we are noting the penetration resistance in the plunger. Okay, so for that it is marked here. Then for next water content, we are noting the penetration resistance, and for next, like this, we are drawing this penetration resistance curve. So in this axis, it is penetration resistance in kilogram per centimeter square. So both this curve is drawn in single graph, so that we can find out water content and dry density for corresponding number of blows. Okay, so this is the final result. This is the Proctor needle. I have told you that there are different needle having different area. Okay, here there is two types of needle, so we can change the needle based on the type of soil. Okay, so this is the calibration of Proctor needle. Okay, this is the calibration curve. Next is the determination of in situ moisture content and dry density. Okay, up to this we have calibrated the Proctor needle. Next we have to find out the moisture content and dry density in the field, whether our compaction is effective. Okay, the soil used for compaction in the field mixed with the placement water content is compacted into compaction mold using the same compaction energy. Okay, for that initially the soil is compacted. Then the Proctor needle with the same needle point as used for preparation of calibration chart is forced into the compacted soil in the mold, and the penetration resistance is determined. That is, if we are doing the compact, if we have to find out the in situ moisture content and dry density of any type of soil, we have to use the needle which has been used for compacting the same soil. Okay, to find out the calibration chart, we'll be using one needle and doing the procedure. So for finding out the in situ moisture content, we have to use the same needle. Okay, so to find out this in situ moisture content and dry density, the Proctor needle is inserted into the soil, compacted soil, and penetration resistance is determined. Okay, then the water content and dry density of the common soil are read from the calibration chart corresponding to the penetration resistance. So this is the method. Okay, that is, we have calibrated like this. In field, we have to find out the dry density and OMC. For that, in field, we are taking the soil and it is compacted in the compacted with water. It is placed in the mold. Okay, and then we are taking the Proctor needle, and this needle is inserted into the compacted soil at the rate of 1.25 centimeter per second, as in the previous procedure, compacted. So we can find out the penetration resistance from the plunger. Okay, so we have now the penetration resistance. So here there is penetration. For example, if the penetration resistance is say 30 kilogram per centimeter square. So penetration resistance will be here. Okay, so for that penetration resistance, we can find out the dry density. We can find out the dry density or water content from this penetration resistance curve, calibration curve. Okay, so here it is 30. If the penetration resistance is 30, what will be the water content here? Water content will be approximately 12 or 14, maybe 14% is the water content. Okay, also the dry density will be from this, if it is 30, take this compaction curve and note down the dry density as 1.65 will be the dry density. Okay, so from this calibration chart, we can find out the value of OMC and dry density for any values of penetration resistance. So this penetration, we have to calculate the penetration resistance of the compacted soil, and from this calibration chart, we can find out the water content and dry density. So it is very simple. So if we are done the calibration, it will be easier. So this is the procedure of Proctor needle. And we can discuss what are the advantages and disadvantages. The main advantage of Proctor needle method is that drying of soil is not required for determination of in situ water content. Okay, this in situ water content we are calculating from calibration chart, so it is very simple. There is no requirement of drying the soil in oven, etc. Okay, so that is the main advantage. And disadvantage is that the actual in situ compaction condition are not truly reflected in dry density and water content determined by this method. That is, in the case of this proctor needle, we cannot attain the same effect which we have applied in the field. In field, we are doing using, that is, in the case of field, the soil is compacted by appropriate roller in specified lift. But in compaction, the mold is done using the rammer by application of blows. Okay, that is, in this here, the condition are different. In field, we are using rollers, but in the laboratory, we are using number of blows using rammers. Okay, so this compactive energy will be different. Like that, in field, we are applying water content at any time. But in laboratory, the water is added to the soil prior to compaction of the soil. But in the case of field, we are applying the water in different stages. So that means we cannot establish the laboratory condition and field condition as same. So the effect will be different. So the result will be somewhat varying. So that is a disadvantage of this proctor needle test. Okay. So this is the field experiment to find out the optimum moisture content and dry density, that is proctor needle test. So this compaction part is over, which is the second part of sixth module, and this first part is slope stability of slopes, that I will be taking in next class. You should read this portion in the textbook. Okay, compaction. So this compaction topic is over. Thank you.